excited about the word. Amen. Because I know it was the word that delivered me. Amen. Come on now. When the devil thought he had me bound, when he thought he had me blind and cut off, God told me that I could still see. Come on now. How many of you have been blind in your life? How many of you couldn't see past the moment? But God gave us a sight that we could never see farther than we were supposed to see. Amen. Oh my God. Trying to look around the corner and I can't see the feet in front of me. Got my hand up in front of me and I can't even see that. But God says, I'll give you the power to see into tomorrow. Oh, come on now. The devil don't want us to believe that. Somebody say, devil, it ain't about you. Woo, God. Come on, Holy Ghost. I thank God this morning, amen, because I know it's about God. See, I'm excited this morning, amen, because somebody gonna get just what they looking for. If it ain't no more but to tell the devil to go back to hell, you gonna get what you looking for. Somebody need the devil to get up off their back and leave me alone. Oh my God. I got to speak to him, amen. You're going to stop cutting up in my house. You're going to stop cutting up on my job. You're going to stop cutting up in my community, because I walk in the authority of God. How many of you are walking in your true God-given authority today? Oh, come on now. You might have fell down yesterday, but if you repent and get back up, you get back with power. Oh, come on now. He said, I rose with all power in my hands. Oh, he didn't rise with that power to himself. He rose with that power to give it to you. Oh, want me to remind you when it happened? Oh, come on. Y'all remember the day of Pentecost when he said, go and wait for the Holy Ghost. And when the Holy Ghost come, you shall have power from God. How many of you got that power this morning? Come on now. Because we can't do nothing aside of it. You can try to put it to the side if you want to. You can try not to hear it if you want to. But guess what you will do? Hallelujah. I'm getting to this word. Let me get into this word. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord.
And if you got your Bibles, and I know you do because you just had them in the air, and you was waving them like you just didn't care. Come on now. It's our party time right now. God's gonna pick us through the fire, amen. Y'all remember the old saying, the roof was on fire. How many of you know right now God has set a fire to begin to deliver you? You got to go through the fire in order not to get burned. The roof is on fire. That'll preach. Write that down. Amen. Amen. And I need y'all to go with me to Luke chapter 18. And I'm going to start at the 19th verse. And when you have it, let me know it by standing upon your feet. Amen. In reverence to the word of God. Luke chapter 18. Oh, wait a minute. No, no, no. Luke chapter 18, starting at the 35th verse. I'm sorry. You don't get this right. I got to get this right. God has been giving me too long. Amen. Amen. And I see the majority is standing, so I will be. And it came to pass that as he was coming nigh unto Jericho, a certain blind man sat by the wayside begging. Hearing the multitude pass by, he asked what it meant. And they told him that Jesus of Nazareth passed by.
All right.
And he cried, saying, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me.
Yes.
And they which went before rebuked him, that he should not, that he should hold his peace. But he cried so much the more, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood and commanded him to be brought unto him. And when he had come near, he asked him, saying, what wilt thou that I should do unto you? And Jesus said unto him, and he said, Lord, that I may receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, receive thy sight, thy faith has saved thee. Father God, I submit myself to you this morning. Father, that you may have your way. I get out the way, Lord God, and I hide behind the cross. For the less of me and so much more of you, God. Father, I ask that you will begin to open up the very throne room of heaven this morning, Lord God. Father, that you, God, will begin to minister to your people, God. Father, feed your sheep this morning. Father, feed us nothing but the word. Feed us until we want no more, God. Father, I pray now that you, God, will give me a triple portion of your anointing, Lord God, that I might operate only in you and not myself. Father, if you don't do it, I cannot do it, God. So, Father, use me for your servants to give your people the word that you have prepared, that you have, God, spoken for this time, for this moment. Father, I ask now that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I just want to bear just a little bit. And he heard it, and hearing the multitude pass by, he asked what it meant. And they told him that Jesus of Nazareth passed by. And he cried, saying, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And they went before, rebuked him, that he should hold his peace. But he cried so much the more, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And if I was going to take for a topic tonight, or this morning, my topic would be, cry now and laugh later. Amen. Come on now. Y'all don't even understand. Now, in the context that we're talking about a blind man. This blind man was given an authority by whomever would give that authority, that you sit in the spot and you beg for what people will give you. Amen. You know that's what the devil wants us to believe that we got to do. The devil wants us to believe that we got to beg for what's already ours. Amen. We got to beg to have peace in our house, and we got to beg to have a position or authority on the job, and we even got to beg for the right person to come in our life that we should marry. How many of you know that God is a God that we should have to be? Oh, but I find it strange that in the process of all of this, he's been there sitting, hollering, crying, alms. Somebody give me something. Somebody help me right now. You ever been in that position where you were so broke, busted, and disgusted, all you wanted was somebody to come and give you a helping hand? Oh, somebody, look at your neighbor and say, cry now.
Cry now.
See, when we begin to cry to Jesus, we begin to know that somebody is going to hear our cry. Yes. Now, the devil don't want us to believe that our cry will be heard. He wants us to think that when we cried out to God, that we were wasting our time. Because guess what? You just messed up yesterday. Here you are before God right now, asking him to help you. But I believe the word tells us to be quick to repent, that we may do what? Continue in our blessing. Amen. Now, see, the thing that I want you to realize is it's not the blessing of the new car, and it's not the blessing of the new job. The blessing is knowing that it was God in me causing things to manifest in my life. Now, a lot of times we'll get to a point in our lives when God will bless us and we'll forget about God. Oh, come on, you know what it's like. I've done it myself. Oh, I'm on top of the world right now. Oh, come on now. work. Oh, you know when things was going good. You got that job making $25 an hour, and that ain't even counting the hustle you got on the side. Oh, y'all hear with me today? Somebody got to know what I'm talking about. Because, see, the devil wants us to think that there's something in us that we're doing that we even deserve to God, that we deserve the love of God. But how many of you know there's nothing that I can do and there's nothing that I can say that makes me worth it?
Right.
Oh, in my best state, I'm still unrighteous. Yeah. The word says my righteousness is as of filthy rags.
Right.
Oh, that means that rag was so nasty, you don't even need to wash it. Just throw it away. Yeah. Now, imagine if God just would have threw us away in the process of our filth.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I hear you.
Now, when I think about this thing, and as this man is sitting on the side of the road crying out, he needs some help, don't he? I can imagine he's sitting there, he can't even see what's happening right now. But see, now let me give you a little educational moment. Now, one thing about our senses, because we know that we're mind, body, and soul. In the process of our body, when one thing fails, there's always another part of you that will begin to work a little bit better.
Yes, sir.
Guess what? If your ears go deaf, you begin to see a little better.
Yeah.
But guess what? If you go blind, then you begin to hear a little bit better. Don't you know our spirit works the same way? When we begin to crucify this flesh, our spirit begins to get a little stronger. When we begin to afflict this body, our spirit begins to walk in the goodness of God. Oh, but you got to afflict the body. You got to put it aside. You got to get in the point where God can begin to deal with the inside of you and get out of the outside of you. Oh, somebody say, it ain't what it look like. See, because when they see you, they see the outside of you, but they don't know there is Jesus on the inside working on the outside and beginning to bring about a change in your life. Somebody say, I need a change. And that change can only come from God. Amen. Now, as Blind Bartimaeus, as we when we study, we'll know that that's the name that they gave him. As he sat on the wayside begging Bishop, he needed some help, didn't he? I can imagine that somehow or another, and this is what I want y'all to get right here, is that as he sat on the side begging, he happened to find his way there every day. Oh, come on now. You ever wonder how is it when I was in my state of sin, I always found myself in the same club. I always found myself sneaking out the same window. I always found myself doing the same old things that I was used to.
Yes.
Oh, come on now. When y'all gonna get out of what you used to? When we begin to get out of what we used to, we can begin to walk into what God has already promised.
Well.
Oh, we say we want the promises of God in our lives, but what do we got to do to obtain the promise of God? Somebody say cry.
Cry.
Oh, see, y'all thought the only way you could cry is because my feelings are hurting or because something ain't going right. But how many times has the word told you that you might be crying tears right now, but every tear you cry, it has a reward of righteousness. If that tear hits the ground, it's going to begin to sprout something up. Every tear you cry, you will begin to sow some victory. You was beginning to sow something that was going to come up a little later on. You was beginning to sow that I'm reaping in my joy right now. Because these tears are falling, I'll reap in joy tomorrow. Oh, the word says that weeping may endure for a night. But what about my joy on tomorrow? Somebody say joy.
Joy.
Now see, you cry now, but your joy is on the way. Because I ain't worried about what I'm crying about. I'm crying where I'm going to. See, we don't realize right now my tears have just recompense of reward. I remember when I was growing up, my daddy used to bless my mom. He was good too, amen. So I don't even have to wonder why she's missing the way she do. Oh my God. See, he used to do things for out of the ordinary. Things that hadn't been done before. It wasn't like him to repeat what he had once done because he always wanted to spring a new trap.
Yeah.
Now see, in the process of that, I used to sit around and look at him and I would watch. She cried again. But daddy ain't did nothing. But then I look at her and she throwing on a new fur coat. And it wasn't just any fur coat. It was one straight from Anastasia fur. It was something that they said he couldn't afford. It was something that if I got to do work 12 hours, 13 hours, I'm going to make sure I bless her.
Amen.
She was crying tears of joy. Now see, I would imagine there was a time when she reaped tears of sorrow. Uh-huh. There was a time when my dad, he ran out there. She had to go get him out the liquor house. She said, I go with my rollers on and my slides. I wasn't fixing up. And my mama was a pistol packing Sally. And guys in her neighborhood say, man, your mama is an OG. I said, y'all just don't know. Amen. But God wants to bless us in the same way, but we scared to show God. Lord, I'll cry over this thing right now. But I'm crying that it's hurting me, but I'm rejoicing because I know you're going to deliver me.
That's right.
My blind Bartimaeus sat there and begged. I can imagine that even those that were right there with him, because you know, you always got those leeches, those hang-alongs, amen. Those ones that, oh, he gonna get a look. Then he gonna click today. He gonna get his today. And guess what he gonna do? He gonna show the love. So they ain't even far behind. Waiting for him. And some of them wanted to. How many of you know that somebody that you used to be with wasn't saved? Or when you got saved, they weren't glad that you got saved.
Amen.
It was a whole bunch of them weren't glad when I got saved.
Amen.
When I came home, they thought I was gonna fall into that same old rut. Oh, give him a little time. Give him a little time. He'll way off. 3 years later, here I still stand before God. Let God do what he had to do. Oh, come on now. It's because I had to cry. Help me, Jesus. But blind Bartimaeus stood by the wayside begging. And people probably gave to him because they felt sorry or somebody felt like it was their Christianly duty. Man, he got those that's on the wayside right there with him saying, brother, you gonna get this today and this is what we're gonna do after a while. But how many of you know until you begin to cry out to God, your situation will never change?
Right.
You will always be in the same format, the same situation, and you will run around in that same circle, joy. Your blessing standing right there. And you're still running in a circle. And God has already promised you, I'm gonna cause your blessings to overtake you. But God ain't nothing overtaking me, but I'm getting tired of it. I'm tired of running around. I'm tired of this. But when is it going to change, Lord? And God says, all you got to do is cry out to me. If you cry out to me, I'll put you on a straight path. So listen, do you realize that in a circle, it's 360 degrees? That means that there are no straight points. That means that everything goes around in a curve. It has angles. But God can only bless you when you're on a street called straight. Oh, come on now. Somebody got to understand what I'm saying. But we want the blessings of God to overflow in our lives when we ain't ready to get on a street called straight. We want to keep running around in circles, chasing. You know, one of the most, I just find this, my little boxer, she'll chase her tail. And it ain't got a tail.
Little boxer.
She don't. But she'll chase it, and she'll turn herself in a circle and, one day I just stopped and I said, Tangie, what you gonna do if you catch it? And she looked at me and twisted her head like, are you crazy? And she went right back to chasing her tail. But we do the same thing. It's because that's what we used to. But God is saying, I'm trying to give you something to get better adjusted to. How many of you know that you can walk in prosperity and be just as comfortable as you was walking in poverty? Let the devil tell me that I can't be a rich preacher and know that God is blessing me and I'm walking in the righteousness of God. Yes, I work hard. Yes, I work 12 hours a day and get paid nothing for the ministry. But God's blessing is on my life because he says he will provide for me every need according to his riches and glory. So it ain't about what I do. It's about what God is doing. Oh, come on, y'all. How many of y'all ready to walk in the will of God? How many of you really need a turnaround? You better begin. In order for a true change to come in my life, guess what? I had to go to prison. Oh my God.
My Lord.
Ooh, Jesus. That was a tough pill to swallow.
Yes.
But guess what? God said, I'm going to give you all. You remember your mom used to give you that casserole? Keep you from getting sick. Here, take this. I'm going to give you this right here to make it go down easy. God said, I'm going to send you in there with the Holy Ghost. So it'll go down easy. But I need you to stay before me. Because if you move to the left or to the right, it'll you'll be out of my sight. Sort of reminds me of a story I heard, and it was this lady had a heart attack. And when she had this heart attack, you know how y'all hear about those after-death experiences, and she had one. And she went up and God told her, she said, wait a minute, you got 40 more years. She said, God, why? She said, wait a minute, you got 40 more years, no panic, everything will be all right. So after the operation is over, the baby don't leave the hospital. She goes in and gets plastic surgery, and she gets a tummy tuck and liposuction. She gets a new nose and gets everything remade. Cause you know she got 40 more years. She walks out the hospital and gets hit by a truck and dies. Gets back to heaven. She said, God, I thought you said I had 40 more years. He said, I didn't recognize you.
Pastor. He is. That was a good one, Pastor.
Come on now. God wants to recognize us.
Yes.
He recognizes your cry.
Yes.
Let me tell you, I'm a grown man and my mama still knows my cry. She knows when I'm hurt.
Amen.
That's right. Our Father recognizes our cry. He recognizes when we're crying out of hurt. He recognizes when we're crying out of anger. He recognizes us. There's no need for us to go get what we don't need when God says, I got everything you need and it's in me. So Brian Bartimaeus began to cry out to Jesus. Jesus! Look, he made it personal. He said, thou son of David. He began to call him by his earthly father. Come on now. But see, y'all don't realize he was talking about King David too. Because that was a part of the prophecy. He knew he had to come out of that lineage. So I recognize you in all of your attributes. I recognize you as pastor. I recognize you as priest. And I recognize you as Lord. And I honor you as King.
Amen.
But as he recognized all of that, here come those ones, those hanger-ons, those I don't have a word for them. Leeches. No, shut up. Don't shut up. Don't holler. Let it go on. Y'all remember the seven sons of Sceva? When he went by him, he told him, he said, Jesus, I know. Paul, I know. But who are you? You speak in the power of Christ. Somebody got to recognize.
Yes.
But as they cried out, he's crying. And they telling him to shut up. Be quiet. How many of you know that's where your help is right there? Your help is in your cry. Your help is where you break down. You so low, I can't do nothing else but cry. And then God will come. Come on now. How many of saints in the old scripture, then we know when they cried out to God, he began to hear them.
Yes,
and some of you say, call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show you great and mighty things which thou hast never seen. We scared to see things we ain't never seen before. Sister Rita ain't never seen nobody give her a call.
Amen.
Come on now. And I've been telling you to get ready for how long. Ooh, just spoke that 2 weeks ago. I said, your car coming because your ride is on the way. And I couldn't get it out my mouth good, but I believe in speaking what God said, speak.
Amen.
Oh my God. Because I said, when we cry out, I hear your cry. He said, my ears ain't so dull that I won't hear your cry.
That's
and my arms are not so short that they can't reach down and help you. Come on now. He is God Jehovah, the great and uncommutable God. There's nothing too hard for him. Don't you know that every situation you got, and this is what we need to realize, children of God, stop looking at your trials as a setback. But you better start looking at your trials as a setup. Set up for me to prosper. Set up for me to walk in my greater. When God has said, I called you to greater, how else you going to get to it unless he leads you to it? Oh, come on now. Some of y'all ain't ready to believe because you have a hard time following me. Uh-oh. Oh, my. But it's the truth. And I'll be the first to tell you, guess what? If I stop following God, stop following me. Come on now. But you know why I got to follow God? Because I want his blessings and the promises to be fulfilled in my life. I want to know. I want y'all to be blessed. I want y'all to walk in the promises of God. I don't want your crying to be in vain. I know you hurt sometimes. I know you're crying because God can put in my spirit to weep with you.
Amen.
I'm weeping with you. So we can prosper later. Walk in the anointings of God. Y'all don't realize that when we cry deeply, when we get that gut lets you cry, that cry when you feel like ain't even no more tears for me to let fall, God says, now you ready. Because you've cleansed your soul. You pour it out in your spirit. And remember how I was telling you, you can't move new furniture in on top of the old. You got to put that old furniture out. Come on now. You might be in a situation in your life you've never been in before. Don't you know your life will change in an instant, in a matter of a moment? I went from having $150,000 in the bank to nothing. Oh my God. How does that happen? Oh, Jesus. And I didn't have to worry about no governmental agent coming taking nothing from me. But I came home and it was $17.97. Thank you, God. Because I never wanted for nothing. Amen.
Amen.
But I had to get some things out the way in order that God could begin to put greater things in the way.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on. We begin to let go. Don't worry about what it used to be. Concentrate on what God said it is going to be. It don't matter how hard it gets right now. It don't matter what they have said about it. It don't matter what it looked like. But God says we walk not by sight, but by faith. Take your eyes off of what it looked like and begin to let me tell you what I want you to feel like. Come on now. Some of you got to feel good before you get good. Walk in your healing before your healing even comes. Oh, come on now. I can't run right now.